in Montessori theory, we always begin at the beginning with the universal before we go to the specific. So, I'd like you to think about our planets that are whirling around our sun, and they're all in a spherical shape, just like these bubbles. If this would represent our planet whirling around in space, and if you would be our sun, Sienna, this is our planet that whirls around you just like this. And around our planet even goes our little moon. So we have three circles that are going around and around and around each other.
Except for Jupiter, he's got 14.
You're right. You are right. And they're all in this amazing spherical shape. Now, our planet has finite resources. On our planet, every single thing is made out of something that starts with a D. And what do you think it is?
Dirt.
Or actually minerals. The whole periodic chart of minerals that makes up all of the elements on our whole planet is what our planet is constructed of. Some of them are in a form that is very hot, and what would that be? It starts with an L.
Evolution?
No, what would it be? It comes out of volcanoes.
Lava!
Lava, right. It can be very hot in a molten core. It can be cooler on the surface of the land, which is actually dirt or minerals. And then there's a little tiny layer that we call a biosphere. Bio. Who knows what that means?
Nope.
Bio. I heard somebody said life. Did you hear that? Bio means life. So there's a little tiny layer of life. And that most of that life has a wonderful color. And that color of that is what?
Green.
Most of that life is green. In fact, she's eating a little piece of that life right now from that biosphere. And there's another element that's on our earth besides our land, and it's blue, and what is it?
Water.
And it's why our sky is blue. It's because of all the moisture and the other elements that are in our atmosphere. Minerals, we have water. Together they produce life with our biosphere, but there's something else we're forgetting over here.
Rain.
That's the water. And she was being it. I was circulating around her. What is that?
Sunlight.
The sunlight, right. All the energy that comes from the outside of our planet comes from our sun. So let's sing this song. Oh, Mr. Sun,
sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me.
Thank you for holding our earth in place. Thank you for making our plants grow. Oh, Mr. Sun,
sun,
Mr. Golden Sun,
Please shine down on me.
So all life on our planet needs sun. It needs water. It needs
soil,
right? And then for that biosphere, there also has that atmosphere that we
breathe,
right? So it needs air. So every single thing that we'll be talking about this whole week needs those four things, the four principles we're dealing with that makes life on our earth. And the reason why there, as far as we know, is not life right now, maybe, on Mars, or there's not life right now, maybe on Venus, or maybe on, you said Jupiter, right?
Mm-hmm. We've got 12.
Right, because they don't have those four things like we do. They don't have the water, they don't have the air, the atmosphere, they don't have the mineral content, and they don't have the correct rays from the sun that get the correct temperature. Every single thing we're going to do is going to involve those four principles. Okay, so let's get started. Repeat after me, you guys. Listen to this. If you want to grow your garden, first you have to grow your soil.
First you have to grow your soil.
Because if you don't grow your soil,
then
you don't have the minerals.
Then you don't have the minerals.
And your plants can't grow.
And your plants can't grow.
So if we have everything else, if we have water, if we have sunlight, if we have lots of oxygen, and we don't have the correct minerals from the soil, our plants will not grow. And this experiment is called soil testing. Okay? Can you hold this up for us, please? You want to sit in this chair right here. He's going to be my holder for our soil testing chart. Okay, this says, test the soil. Okay, number one. Okay, here's what we'll do. Here's our soil testing jar. Would you hold this for me, Sienna? Oh, before we get started, though, my special helpers have to have their special outfits on. First, they need to put on their what, you guys?
Aprons.
Okay, an apron for you. And with Ramon. Now, Ramon's earning his Boy Scout badge here. I'm so proud of him.
Actually, my dad's a wolf, and that's pretty much it.
Pretty much it? Okay. All right. Okay, they both have their gloves, and now they need to get their... Now they need to put on their gloves. Okay. Now, go ahead and put it on, babe. Put this right down here. Okay, so Sienna has my jar here because we're going to do a science experiment. And what we're going to learn how to do, this is very, very important. This is a principle of education everywhere, is all teachers and all students have to learn to use your eyes to, what do you use your eyes for?
See. Oh,
to see. And when you see, you observe. And then when you see things, you understand in your head, and you can figure out, why is this happening or why is that happening? So, we're going to observe this soil test. So, step number one is we have to put soil. Now, Angel, where'd you get this soil, honey?
Over there by the tree.
She just got it just out of this yard here. This is no particular fancy soil. It's just plain old soil. Arizona soil. First, we'll take the lid off.
That would help.
Now, Essence, would you put this in here, sweetheart? Let's put three scoops in. One. Two. Three. Okay. Now, so the step number one says, what does it say, Claudia? Pour in water. Pour in water. Okay. Now, Essence, would you pour some water in here, sweetheart? Let's get the water all the way up to this label. Okay, that's good. Now, step number two. This is testing our soil. For step number two, we have to put some soap in here, some detergent. And what this detergent does is it disperses the particles. Okay, now Chinua is going to put a good squirt. Squirt it in, babe. Okay, that's enough, I think. Now, Chinua, would you put the lid on this? Sorry, dear. All right, let's get on here really tightly. All right. Now, we don't want this to leak it. Might a little bit. You want to shake it up, sweetheart? Do it over here so it doesn't shake on you. Shake it, shake up the soil. Now what they're doing is that is dissolving. Who knows what dissolve means? Do you know what that means? Do you know what it means, sweetheart? The dirt does what in water when it dissolves? Anybody know?
It
disappears because the dirt spreads off. What does it do?
It disappears and it goes somewhere else.
It disappears and it goes somewhere else. And where it goes is out in the molecules of water. All the little particles from the elements actually disperse and they get dissolved into the water. Okay, now let's see what's happened here. Okay, whoa, look at that. This is incredible. Okay, now we're going to put this down for 1 minute.
Looks like hot chocolate.
Now, Here's what we need to see, Ramon.
Don't drink
okay.
Exactly.
Now, step number two was shake it up and let it settle. This is what we're doing. Now, step number three, good. All right, we're gonna look and see now if we have layers. Now, in this chart, The layer that's down at the bottom is sand. And what's sand made out of, you guys?
Soil rocks.
Rocks, little rocks, so it's going to be heavy, right? So the sand will go down at the bottom.
Bam.
Now, level number two is going to be this black part here.
Soil.
This is called clay. Can you say that?
Clay.
And in Arizona soil, clay or caliche, there's a lot of that clay. Now, what do you make clay out of? Let's see, what could you make with clay?
You can pots? You can make boulder boards, and then you flatten them and make like boots and toys.
Yeah, you can make lots of things. But you know what? If you make toys and pots, they're hard, aren't they?
Yeah.
So that clay, if there's a lot of clay in our soil, it'll be just like us trying to plant into a pot, a hard pot. Would that work? I don't think so. So we have our sand, then we've got our clay, and the next layer that we have on the top, this brown thing here, this is called organic material. Can you say that?
Organic
material. What's organic material, you guys? I'll give you a hint. Leaves, sure. It's roots, things that at one point were alive. And organic material does something really interesting to the soil. It makes, whenever I pour some water into this organic material, which is dry grass, it acts like a sponge. And what's it going to do to the water? It absorbs the water. And look, I can squeeze it out just like a sponge. Isn't that neat? That's what organic material does. It holds water. It also holds, in the soil, holds what?
Air.
Air, exactly. And plants, we figured out those four things. So now we have, it holds water, it holds air. And the other thing that plants need to live, it starts with an M, it's those
minerals.
Minerals, exactly. This has minerals in it because this actually grew from the soil. This is all made out of minerals. In fact, everything in the whole world you could say is made out of minerals or even dirt. I love that, dirt or soil. So dirt's pretty important. So we got these three things going right here from this organic material. Now, Exactly. You are right. Now let's look. Oh, look at this. This is already layered out. Can you see? Look down at the bottom. Look at all that sand. See the lighter level? You guys see? Look at that sand. Okay. Then on top of that, there's a little bit that's a little bit lighter. I'll turn around this way. Hopefully you can see. Can you see the clay there? And on the very top, there's a black layer of organic material. It's about that thick.
I can't see clay.
Can you see that? This would not be good to grow in, I don't think, because there's a lot of sand. Can plants eat sand? Use sand? Nope. Can plants eat that hard? Use that hard clay? What they really need is more of the stuff. More of this organic material. That's really what they need. So we know that this natural soil for our garden would not work. If we planted seeds out there, the seeds could not get what they really need. They couldn't get the minerals that they really need. So now we know we better amend this soil. Who knows what amend means? To amend means like we're going to add something to it. That'll change it. That'll make it better. So let's try this. Okay. All right. Whoa. These are just bubbles. These bubbles.
Can I see?
Yeah, these are just some bubbles I had from here. Okay. Isn't that neat? That is neat. Okay. Now, we want to get less sand, less clay, and more organic material. Okay. So, Junior, would you put a little handful of this in here?
Wow, that's going to be a lot.
Okay. Claudia, can you get me a leaf from here? Squish it all up.
This? A live one or
what? Yeah, this one right here. Squish it all up. Yeah, squish that all up. Good. Now, then, this is some soil that already has, see that nice dark color? This is some soil that already has, it's already has plant material that's broken down in it. So would you pour some of this in here, about half? Okay, good. Now, let's try this again. All right, let's do our shaking over here, you guys. Woo! Shake up the soil. Oh, they're into it. Okay, sweetheart.
Shake it like you really mean it.
Shake it like you really mean it. Okay.
Like you're mad at it.
Like you're really mad at it. Now, we have a sponge. Are you going to wipe this off so we can see a little bit, sweetheart?
Okay,
good.
Okay, that's good.
Now, oh, already, you guys. We still have this layer of sand. Can you see the light layer of sand?
Yeah.
We still have a layer of caliche or clay, but look on the top. Instead of that little bitty layer of organic material, we have almost this much of organic material. Now, if we would plant in this, could plants grow? Okay, let's try it. Okay, this is just what we're going to do. We'll let this settle a little bit more, and we'll look at it even more later. It says, test the soil. Can you guys say that?
Test the soil.
Now, in order to grow really, really healthy, your plant needs to have, think about this, okay? What does it need to have?
Water.
Rain.
It needs to have
sun. It needs to have
soil.
Right? And it needs to have, look guys, what's this last thing? You wouldn't think a plant has to have
love.
This.
Love.
Air.
And you know what? You know what he said? He said love. And Harry knows plants grow better with love. Did you guys know my grandpa was a farmer? And he loved his plants so much that all his seeds grew better than anybody else's? You know, that's right. People might not think that's true, but his grew better than anybody else's because he loved his plants. I love is what you need. Okay, but we're going to test our soil. Now, you guys said we need to have healthy soils. So Harry says, okay, here is our scientific question. Think about this. Is the soil in our garden good for plants?
Yeah.
Who thinks it's good for plants to grow?
No.
You think it's good?
No.
Oh, well, who thinks it's not good for soil? I mean, for our plants to grow? It's about half and half. Who doesn't know for sure? I don't know for sure.
I don't know for
sure. You know,
sure.
If we think about it, I think actually maybe most of us don't know for sure. So you know how we can find out? Test the soil. Let's do it. Okay. Now, this is our jar, right? But Caitlin is going to open this up for us. This is our soil jar. It's a little tight. That's good because it's not going to spill. Well, Miss Jodine?
No.
Sorry.
Did you?
Okay, good. Now, we'll put this right here. We'll put this right here. Now, let's see. Let's write. Now, scientists have to label things. Therefore, I have something we're going to use. Okay. So, how do we spell your teacher's name?
Betty.
Miss
B-E-T-T-Y.
With one
Betty.
T or two?
Two.
Miss Betty. Okay. Miss Betty.
B-E-T-T-Y.
Okay. So we know this is Miss Betty's class because we already did this experiment with two other teachers. So this we'll know is Miss Betty's, okay? We'll label it. Here, babe, you hold this for me, and let's put the label right here on our very nice science jar. Okay, now, okay, we need to have three things. We need what?
A watering can.
We need to have some
water.
Soil. You're exactly right. This is soil from our garden. You guys take a look? Okay. If everybody would sit down, you know what? I think it works better because I'll take the soil out in the shovel and then everybody can see it, okay? That'll work better. So, we've got water, we have soil, and we need something very surprising. Got a little basket. Who is this?
Soap.
Can you imagine we need soap? This is plain old detergent. And the good thing about this detergent is it does something very interesting with the soil. Have you guys ever had a really greasy plate you're washing?
Yeah.
And the grease just doesn't come off?
Yeah.
What happens when you put soap in it?
It comes off.
Sure. Soap does this wonderful thing. It causes...
It does.
Even the oil and the dirt on your skin. Soap helps it to disperse the dirt. Now, this is an interesting word. Can you say, it starts with a D. Let's see. Disperse the dirt. Disperse. Okay. Now, you're going to see. I got to get my sleeves rolled up here, boy, because we are ready to do this work. Now, we are going to disperse the dirt with our detergent. Okay. Now, take your... Okay. You're going to take your shovel. Okay? You guys look at this. I've got the shovel. Now, this soil is directly from your garden. Look at that. That's a big clump of soil. Okay? Now, let's put this in the jar. You want to put it in the jar? Plump. Now, she needs to put the water in the jar, right? You know, you guys, let's fill it up to the top right here where the label is, okay? Pour the water in.
Ew.
Ooh, I think it looks great. Something amazing is happening. Do you know what this is called? You know what's happening?
What?
You know what's happening? Is this soil is doing a very interesting thing. It is dissolving. Can you say that? Dissolving. That means all the particles from this soil are going out everywhere in this whole, your whole little cup of water. Now come over here, sweetheart. Why don't you sit here by Harry a little bit? Okay. I'm going to move Harry over a little bit. Thank you, Harry. So there's room for us. Now, you want to come right here, sweetheart?
Yeah.
Why don't you come right here in front of me, okay? Now.
Okay,
Harry. He's okay. There you go, Harry. Can you sit right there? Now, she's going to take the lid. She's going to put the lid on top. She's going to do what?
Shake it up.
Okay, here, babe, you help me. Okay. Now, you guys say this with me. Shake it. Shake it. It's a little drippy, so this is why we're doing it over the pail. Shake it. Shake it. Now, let's look. It looks just like chocolate milk. It does.
Oh, man. It looks like a hot chocolate fudge.
It does. Let's shake it one more time. Shake it. We are sure now that this is all, what's that word I use? That death? Dissolved. Okay, now, I am going to do something here. I'm going to put this right here so you can see what happens. We forgot one ingredient. Take the lid off.
It's a soap.
Take our soap. Make a squirt. Because we need to disperse all the particles that are dissolved in our water. I love those D words, don't you?
I can't see, Ruthie.
Yeah, Ruthie, if you'll sit on your bottom, then I can see. You guys ready for the shake thing?
Yeah.
Ready? Okay. Shake it. Oh, look at the suds. Shake it. All right. Now, it really looks like chocolate or coffee.
Yeah, it looks like coffee.
Let's see what's going to happen. Now, while we're looking, scientists are very tidy. We have a little drip. She's going to clean that up. I think that she'll also clean this off right here.
Oh, a bubble.
You see a bubble?
Yeah, a bubble.
Now, you guys, something very interesting is happening. We're starting to have these layers just like she showed us. Look, we're starting to have clay. We're starting to have sand. And we're starting to have some organic material. But the sad thing is, it's looking to me, it looks like this. A whole lot of sand, a whole lot of clay, and I don't see very much organic. In fact, you know what? I don't see any organic material. I think I got, whoa, I don't see any. That's pretty amazing. Now, our scientific question was, is our soil good for something to grow in?
No.
You're right. You are exactly right. It's not good because we don't have enough of some really important stuff. I'm going to have you. Let me see. He's going to tell us what we really need to have this grow. Let me see. What is it, Henry? He says we need to have more organic material. Do you guys know what that is?
No.
Organic material. You can make it from grass. You can make it from leaves. Let's see, what else?
Oh, I know.
What do you think?
Bark from a tree.
Bark from a tree? What a good idea.
I know.
What do you think, sweetheart?
From branches.
You are so smart, from branches. You have it. You guys, you know what we can
That's
even do?
That's what I was going to say.
Do you want to recycle our lunch here at school?
Yes. Yeah. No.
You know what?
No. We can recycle even the use trash.
Exactly. You know, you can even make compost out of dirt. I mean, out of paper. Isn't that amazing?
Hello?
Yeah, but you know, if we recycle your lunch, let me see. Now, I don't think that your garden would like to have meat. Do you think it would?
No. Yeah.
But do you think it would like to have lettuce?
Yeah.
Do you think it would like to have banana peels?
Yeah.
No.
Apple cores?
Yeah.
Broccoli?
Yeah.
Yes, all those kinds of things. Okay. Now, since we don't have, listen, you guys, since we don't have any organic material yet, because Mr. Dean said, can we go ahead and recycle our lunch?
Yeah.
Can we start our own compost?
We can, yes.
So Ms. Jodine, whenever we cut the grass, we can put it into our compost?
Of course.
Okay,
of course.
Let's do that. However, you guys, today we don't have any compost. Therefore, Harry brought something for us. What'd you bring, Harry? Harry brought some compost for us. Do you guys know? Do you know what could plants get out of compost? It's really the same thing you need. What do you think?
Food,
exactly.
It's like this kind of fertilizer.
Yeah, fertilizer. You're right. And plants can get minerals and vitamins, things they really need from compost.
Water and sand.
Yep. So, now, Miss Jodine, would you carry this around? Because you can, it's a little bit hard to see because the layers right here. You know, I see only sand and only clay, and I don't see any compost in here at all. If you look, it looks much more like this one.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Here's the clay.
So what you're doing now is a very important step that scientists do. I'm wondering if you know this word, Ruthie. Gracie. I'm wondering if you know this word. It's called, it's another word for looking. Scientists do it all the time.
Observation.
You know it, observation. So look, as Miss Jodine takes your scientific experiment around, what you are doing is observation. You are observing that how our soil test is working. Therefore, sweetheart, please don't do that. Therefore, do you think that our soil is good to grow in?
No way.
Did you? No way. You are right. You are exactly right. And Miss Jodine, they learn that by observing.
That's
Isn't that
right.
amazing?
They're scientists.
We got scientists going here. Now, Harry has a solution. He thinks. Now, let's see. Now,
see that, Ethan?
All right.
This is
Harry has a solution.
This is the clay, but there's no organic material.
No vitamins in the soil. Now, my helper can get a scoop of this compost right here, babe. Okay.
Here's the sand down here.
Now, this is compost that somebody already made, but we're going to make our very own, aren't we?
Yeah.
You know, we're not going to waste one thing, are we?
No.
Because, Miss Jodine,
mm-hmm.
put that down. Thank you. Because if we don't waste lunch scraps, right? If we don't waste grass, if we don't waste leaves from our garden, we're going to have good soil to use. Now, here's an idea. Think about this, okay? Put out your finger. I want you guys to sing this song with me. Put out your finger, sweetheart, okay? And Harry will show us. This is a special song. Harry, I want you guys to learn this song because he thinks it's really important. Okay, put your hand out. Everything runs in a circular motion. Life is like a dance between air, land, and sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. Nature shows the way to set us all free, to give and receive love, to give and receive life. Let's try it now. Everything runs in a circular motion. Life is like a dance between air, land, and sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. Nature shows the way to set us all free, to give and receive life, to give and receive life. So, if we don't waste anything, I think that we're going to have good vegetables and fruits growing in our garden. Now, see all the bubbles?
Yeah.
My sweet little assistant here is going to put in a scoop of compost.
Wow.
Yeah. That's a big one, isn't it?
Cool.
Okay, scoop of compost.
Put some more compost.
Now, she's going to close it up for us.
Shake, shake, shake.
And we are, you guys ready?
Here. Yeah.
Shake it. Ah! It looks different already. Isn't that amazing? Well, let's try that one more time. Shake it. Okay. Now, I'll put it right here and let's see what happens.
It looks like it's fizzy.
It does. It looks all fizzy.
No,
now, we'll let our scientists clean up any soil while we're doing this. Miss Jodine, it's amazing. Miss Betty's class, look, already, it's, you know, you can see layers. It's incredible. It's incredible.
Is there organic
look what
material
happened.
In the top?
I can't believe this. Look, you can see, if I turn it this way, you can see even better. Look, you can see, look, there's a layer of sand. Okay? And then on top of that, there's a layer of clay, but it's very thin. It's kind of hard to see. I'll pass it around.
I can see it.
The lighter right there is the sand. It's really heavy. It's down at the bottom. Then the next layer is that clay. And you think, you know, boy, could plants grow in clay? No. But look at all this, a huge layer of organic material. And it's even up at the top. Miss Jodine, you want to pass this around?
Yeah.
It's amazing that this fast we could see results from our scientific experiment. She'll pass it around. That is amazing. You look at that.
Up here. Organic material, vitamins and minerals.
You know what? Look, it's just like our chart. So, first we had our cup, right? Then we put, come here, show, sweetheart, you want to point? Then we poured in, what did we pour in?
Water.
Then we put in soil or dirt from our garden. Then we put in our
soap
because that's going to disperse all the particles. And then we put on the, what we put on the top?
Lid.
And then we did shake it. So it all dissolved.
Okay. Organic material.
And the first time, a lot of
sand,
a lot of clay, not very much of the organic material. But look, the second time, show us what happened, babe. This is what you guys are looking at as Mr. Dean goes around. Look at that! Organic material.
Organic material.
A little bit of sand, a little bit of clay. All right.
Sand.
clay and the organic.
Isn't that amazing? You know, Miss Betty, where should we put that in your classroom? Because we'll leave the science experiment here. Okay? Because, you know, already the longer this sits, the more you can see. Just like in her diagram, after a while, the water will be clear. And you'll see the sand. Okay, you guys tell me, you're going to see sand, then what? Clay, and then what? Organic material. All right. Now, therefore, you guys, when you go out to the garden this week, everybody, come here, sweetheart. There's a bunch of clay. You are right. Everybody's going to put on your apron. Everybody is going to do what?
Put on your glove.
Everybody is going to get a shovel.
And one of those little rake things.
Get a rake. Everybody is going to dig in the soil, and I'm going to show you exactly how you're going to dig in the soil.
I don't know who you are. You're Darby's mom.
Because watch, you're going to know when you're trying to go outside. Now, this is soil, just like our garden. Okay? Use your rake, honey, and dig in here. That process is called something very interesting. It's giving the soil air. So we call this aeration. He's going to aerate the soil. Isn't that neat? Now, then he's going to take his shovel and he's going to get a shovel of compost, and there'll be a bucket out there. You guys can, you can see it when you're outside. You guys can see all these things. It's going to be so neat for you. He's going to take his shovel of compost. Dump it in his soil. Go ahead, babe. Dump it in. Then he's going to take his rake again, and he's going to mix it all up. By the time you guys do that, will everything be ready to grow?
Yeah.
Harry will be so happy. Great, honey. Thank you.